Good evening. For decades, he interviewed the world's most famous people, but Sir Michael Parkinson inadvertently became one himself. Tonight, he's being remembered as the king of the chat show and one of a kind who was always himself. The titan of television and cricket tragic died surrounded by his family at the age of 88.
Good evening and welcome.
During the golden age of television, he set the gold standard for interviews.
I think you've got to accept, John and Yoko, that it's alienated you from the people who originally loved you in this country.
A lot of them, yeah.
Yes, I think they don't understand you anymore.
The alienation started was when I met Yoko.
If you got to sit down next to Sir Michael Parkinson, you knew you'd made it as a bona fide celebrity.
Do they think you're too pushy, perhaps? Is that what they think?
A bit too pushy. I'm sure some people do.
Why are you laughing? Well, you've been voted the sexiest man of the century, for God's sake.
Well, they have great taste.
Over four decades and a best guess of more than 2,000 interviews, he asked the right questions and, most importantly, he listened.
Michael did it differently. He loved people. He loved the Hollywood stars that came on. He loved the sports of football and cricket that he had. And he just chatted to him, he always said, as if he was in his front room.
Parky, as he was affectionately known, was born in 1935, the son of a coal miner who was desperate he not end up in the pits. Instead, he became a journalist, first in newspapers, before television came calling in the 60s. In 1971, he started the program that made him a household name. He didn't always get it right. It was a different time when he had this exchange with a young Helen Mirren.
Do you find that your figure, your physical attributes, which people are always going about, hinder you?
It's because serious actresses can't have big bosoms. Is that what you mean?
And his interview with Meg Ryan was one he wished he could do again.
If you were me, what would you do now?
Well, just wrap it up.
But overwhelmingly, he's being remembered as an interviewer who got to the heart of his subject, retaining his own authenticity in the process. Perhaps ironic, then, that his favourite guest was the greatest, Muhammad Ali.
I'm not going to argue with you.
You're not as dumb as you look.
For Michael Parkinson, Australia was a second home.
And what I liked about Australia was I never had to think, do I like it or not? From the very moment I arrived here, I enjoyed it.
He brought his talk show here in 1979 and interviewed some of our icons.
A tap dancing knife thrower.
Good at it too.
Hello, darling.
Hello, dear.
Here we are again. Isn't it spooky?
Tell us a story about the boomerang. I love this story.
I've still got the scar here.
This is a metaphor for your life, you know, this is.
Sort of threw the boomerang and didn't quite get it right. And then once I got it right and sort of just kept going around, I thought, oh, that's pretty good. And suddenly it started coming towards me. I thought, geez, I better try and catch that.
I mean, how much of a shock was it to you, the actual business of getting a divorce?
Michael!
This one I'm not quite sure about. Performs like a playboy? I have my moments.
His interviews felt like a chat with a trusted friend.
You've always said that you're not gay.
You know, I've thought about this for a long time.
I bet, yeah.
I'm not straight.
You're not.
He was a gentleman. He was in the right place at the right time. He gave respect to everybody, and he got it back in spades.
4 years ago, Richard Wilkins swapped places with the interviewer's interviewer.
How important is that first question?
I've never been asked that before.
The last time we saw Michael Parkinson, a TV interview last November.
But there's that moment when you're actually doing an interview. You come to a point where you know, you can see it in their face, you can see it in their relaxed posture, that they've joined you in a conversation. You've got it, you've caught the fish. But that's the moment you look for.
His great friend, Dickie Bird, said his goodbyes yesterday.
We said goodbye to each other at the end of the phone call, as if we had this feeling that we wouldn't see each other. Excuse me.
Michael Parkinson spent his final moments surrounded by family, but news of his death reverberated around the world. A real icon, said Elton John. Broadcaster Piers Morgan called him the GOAT of TV interviewers. David Beckham wrote, "We say goodbye to the best." And comedian Stephen Fry sang what Parky might have liked most. He was always 100% himself, on camera and off. Sir Michael Parkinson was 88.
Good night.
Nine's Europe correspondent Carrie-Anne Greenbank is live from the old BBC studios in London. And Carrie, Sir Michael leaves quite the legacy.
Georgie, he does, along with actors, comedians, sports stars and TV celebrities all lining up to pay tribute to Sir Michael. You can see the impact he had on the public by taking just a quick look at the British newspapers. Almost all of them are leading with him, are displayed prominently on the front pages, including The Sun, with the title The Greatest, which is a reference to him and also Muhammad Ali, who he interviewed multiple times. But there's a really touching tribute at his much-loved Yorkshire Cricket Club as well. Fans stood up with players for a minute's silence to honour the life of the veteran broadcaster. And the BBC also changed its programming to run a documentary about his life. Georgie?
Carrie-Anne Greenbank in London, thank you.